you're out there. Living on the edge of what's possible. The talented, the ambitious, the inspired. We're out there too. Artists of vision, production, and technology alike. Drawn toward each other by a common passion. To share a moment with the world. At Ross, we live in live moments, no place else. For over 40 years, we've shared the thrill of creating the most important live productions on Earth. Yours. On screen. Together, we are living live.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage President and CEO of Ross Video, David Ross.
Hi there. Welcome to the Ross NAB keynote. Thank you for coming. How'd you like our new opening video? We created that video to introduce our new tagline, Living Live. We believe Living Live reflects what we have become as a company. At Ross, we don't just ship a box. We're out there with you every step of the way, often on site, to help you deliver amazing live productions. We're living live here tonight. We're working with our customer, LMG, to produce this keynote. Ross Technology is running the big screens behind me, as well as delivering live streams to YouTube and Facebook. There's quite a few people watching too. This production is powered by Expression Tessera, Carbonite, Furio, Acid Cam, Frontier, UX, Ultrix, Open Gear, Dashboard, Inception. Personally, I think that's pretty cool, and I think it's unique in the industry. Speaking of the industry, there's a lot going on right now. Struggling companies, leadership changes, consolidation. As a customer, it's important that you invest in companies that'll be there for you over the long haul. So how's it going at Ross? Well, this year, we're having some fun, and we're presenting our graph using augmented reality, all using Ross technology, of course. Let's see the graph. Last year was a challenging year for the industry, but Ross still managed to grow by yet another 6%. This extends our streak to an unprecedented 26 consecutive record years. Even better, our first quarter was the most profitable in our entire history. That makes it possible for us to invest even more into exciting products that will be revealed in future keynotes. So far this year, we're up another 15% year over year, putting us on track for an amazing 2018. So thank you to our customers, our business partners, for your continued support and for being an important part of our shared success. Thank you. This growth has also allowed us to keep expanding our offices around the world. Over the past year and a half, we've doubled the sizes of our offices in London and Singapore, making them full Ross Experience Centers and support hubs. We've also opened a beautiful new facility in Sydney, Australia. These are important investments to improve our customer experience around the world. Okay, let's start talking about products. Last year, we took the top-of-the-line Cambot 700XY pedestal and produced two cost-effective variants, the Cambot 600XY S3 and the Cambot 600XY S2. They were very popular. Adding these products made it possible for customers who were previously using multiple fixed cameras to have fully roaming pedestals for the same system cost. For many customers, This was a revolution in what was possible. Last year as well, we introduced the Furio SE, our beautiful new three-stage lift and dolly. We're using one right there. Taller, faster, stronger has been our punchline for this product. It's an amazing piece of technology, and it sets the bar for the very top levels of live production. This year, we're excited to announce the Furio S2. Using the same philosophy of the new cost-effective CAM bots, we're now able to offer a more cost-effective Furio. This new Furio configuration saves 25% in the cost of the dolly lift combination. For customers that don't need the added lift range and height of the Furio SE, the Furio S2 now makes the smooth motion shots that Furio is famous for a possibility. Other than the vertical range and height, the S2 has the same amazing performance specifications as its big brother, the Furio SE. Woo! That's our first product introduction. Of course, you can mix and match any combination of robots that you want because all the Furios and the CAMBots use the same ROS smart shell control system. I just love how the robotics development team at ROS is really on a roll. To tell you even more about what's going on at ROS, I'd like to introduce our Executive Vice President and Chief Marketing Officer, Mr. Jeff Moore.
Thank you, David. So David introduced Living Live, which I think really communicates the passion of our teams when working with clients to push the creative envelope. The way we think about that, we call it smart production. And it's all about using technology to deliver creative and business benefits to our clients. To help you do this, we have a team of solutions architects with enormous industry and production expertise, and of course, a lot of detailed ROS knowledge. And they'll work with you to craft a solution enabling intelligent and efficient workflows. They'll come in, they'll assess your current systems and processes, make recommendations, and create a tailored solution that goes beyond the obvious. Here's an example. On-location production for sports, where people and equipment go on-site to produce an event with big costs in travel and expenses and often poor equipment utilization. Many are trying to solve this problem and save money by keeping most of the crew and equipment at home with just those required on site. ROS Solution Architects have done this one better, working with clients to create integrated workflows and custom control systems that maximize utilization, deliver higher operational efficiencies, and more consistent results. Okay, so let's go inside the stadium where ROS has really moved workflow forward at major venues, not just driving the main displays anymore, which are bigger and higher res every year, but also driving LED ribbon boards. We're driving water fountains. We're driving audio systems, mechanical devices, light systems. We can drive an entire stadium with one button push. We make this possible with Dashboard, our facility control system. Dashboard controls almost anything, and its custom panel feature makes it super simple to do complex things. Here are an array of custom panels created by ROS, our business partners, and our customers. The one on the end is the Adelaide Oval Cricket Grounds in behind me here in Australia. And ROS and our business partner, Kojo, put this together. Let's have a look at the results. Yeah. Wasn't that cool? A big thank you to Kojo and the Adelaide Oval for that amazing example of what dashboard and full venue control is all about. So in North America, sport venues have gone to screens of massive scale in both size and resolution. Here's a simplified block diagram in behind me. On the left, we've got Expression Tessera up in the top. It's our graphic system for massive resolution displays, and multiple expression engines are used to drive those displays pixel accurately, producing the highest quality images. Below that, we've got the control room. That's feeding live video and replays to the screen. In this case, video is scaled to those screens in a video image processor. This video image processor layers Expression Tessera and the control room output. And until tonight, that box has come from someone other than Ross. Ready for this? Tonight, I am thrilled to announce Carbonite Mosaic, a brand new video image processor from Ross Video designed to drive these massive displays. So here are the specifications. It's got a 20 plus million pixel raster size, 36 inputs, 10 tile outputs with 5 layers each, 18 scaling engines, HDR conversion, color correction in and out, 1 frame of latency. It's dashboard native, of course, so you can do all those cool things with dashboard, and it is half the price of the competition. That's cool. Also, I am very pleased to announce our first client to be using Mosaic, the Atlanta Hawks. Yeah, thank you. So moving on to Expression, our real-time motion graphics platform, which is at the heart of these productions and is so core to sports, news, and entertainment programming, which revolve around graphics to help tell the story. Expression is there at the highest level. And at NAB this year, we're bringing new editions of Expression hardware and software to the show. So let's start with hardware. We've got a brand new platform, the M7 platform. Right here in behind me, it uses the latest motherboard, CPU, GPU, SSDs, and we've got a 2-rack unit chassis, brand new 2RU chassis, as well as a 4RU chassis, supporting SDI, IP, and 12 gig versions. This works with our new software, Expression version 8 software, and we've got upgraded Expression licensing here for you at the show with new enhanced versions of Expression. So the first one, Expression Single Channel Edition, it now includes a preview channel. Expression Studio, which was a dual before, now becomes a triple with preview. And then we've got Expression Studio Flex, the high-end system with 4 channels or 1 UHD channel. And we can scale from one to the next just with software without having to change the hardware anymore. You're welcome. Okay, so existing Expression customers is the best part. With current maintenance, we'll automatically be upgraded to these new versions. And in the future, when they upgrade their hardware, they'll unlock new channels. Expression version 8 is a whole lot more than that, though. It adds new features, options, and products to the Expression family. So let's take a look at a couple of new products first. So Expression Tessera, I mentioned, we've got a new single-engine edition of Expression Tessera, which brings those giant stadium workflows down into a smaller package, great for on-set monitors. And coupled with that, we've got Expression Tessera MOS. So we've got a MOS workflow for automated workflows for your on-set monitors in addition to your production graphics for news. So that's really cool. We've got FBX import for 3D models. We have a brand new API for dashboard that really is very sophisticated and allows us to build much richer applications in dashboard that drive Expression now. It's got an Adobe Premiere plugin, so you can use your Expression templates in Adobe Premiere. And it's got HDR and wide color gamut support. Okay, so that's expression. You'll have to come by and see it at the show. Moving on to augmented reality and virtual sets, ARVS. ARVS has really been taking off in the past. In the past, it was just too complex. With Ross's end-to-end solution, it's much, much easier now. ARVS can provide better studio utilization, increase flexibility, and improve your production look. It enables new sources of revenue, like in-scene advertising, and a whole lot more. It brings a lot of benefits. And Ross brings end-to-end solutions. So let's have a look at one of our recent ARVS customers who implemented a system earlier this year, the innovative WRAL from Raleigh, North Carolina. Let's have a look.
This was the first really big, full production, all green screen studio attempt at doing program length content. We decided that Ross Video was the place to go for this particular project. And they have worked really well with us to help us get this project up and running.
I think expression is very powerful. The reason is compared to the 3D program like Cinema 4D, what I used to do, it takes hours to render. And in the news environment, we don't have that luxury. So this is a 3D program live. And that is something most of 3D application cannot do.
Everybody's looking at costs, and we know the material costs of building sets. And this is a great combination of lowering those costs and increasing the creative potential exponentially. I started in TV production in the 70s. I've seen it all. And this is one of the most stunning developments in terms of what creative people can do and how the graphics box and the robots then present it is pretty stunning, I have to say. Was it a surprise? No, but did it exceed my expectations? I think it did. I think the limits are way, way out there. And we're going to see whatever we can do to use this technology to its fullest.
That was super slick. So a big thank you to WRAL for the use of that video. So last year, Ross and the Future Group launched Frontier, our virtual and augmented reality system, which uses Epic Games' Unreal Game Engine, bringing game engine technology to virtual. It's been used on some really cool productions. This year, we're bringing Frontier 2.0, which adds talent reflections in virtual environments, improvements to internal compositing, and a whole lot more. So, let's have some fun. Let's have a look at Frontier in action. So I want you to check out the side screens. Last year, we had Virtual Jeff. This year, we've got Digital Dave. So here's Digital Dave in his hometown Ottawa Senators hockey jersey. We created this avatar with a photometric scan. Here's Dave over here in the scanning rig. We generated a model and touched it up a bit. Then we downloaded various motion capture animation templates. We connected them into his skeleton to make him move. And this is the result. So let's check out Dave's stats as a hockey player. Look at the penalty minutes. Not good, Dave, not good. Okay, who wants to see what else he can do? Huh? What do you got, Dave? What do you got? Huh? Okay, you got more? What else can you do? Can you dance? Okay, Digital Dave, we're done with you now. Thanks. Okay, I think you get the idea that AR can really spice up a production. Well, that's it for me. And to take us back to real Dave, we've got a blast from the past. Our founder, John Ross, and some of the work that got it all started. Thank you.
we'd like to introduce you to a young man who's built a very remarkable machine. The machine you've seen before, at least you've seen it working, but I don't think you've ever seen behind the scenes. I'd like to introduce, first of all, John Ross. John, say hello. And John is the young man who has built, well, what do you call it, John?
I call it the video effects amplifier, Warren. Yes, this is all the remote control unit for all this equipment here.
And there are your 60-some-odd tubes, huh?
Yes, that's the majority of it.
It's complex. It does some amazing things. Suppose you put it through its paces now, John, and the various kinds of wipes, and we'll see just what it can do. Some amazing effects. I've seen you use this. I've seen it often on the Ernie Kovacs show when they did that summer show a year ago, where they had one person sort of appearing suddenly by magic in front of another picture. Now, how does that operate, or at least can you show it to us?
That's our floor director, and we're going to put him into another picture.
Gary Plaxton, and there's a
station break slide. And here's the final result.
That's amazing. Well, tonight we've had a chance to meet John Ross, the man who's, a 21-year-old man who's had the wit and foresight to build what I consider a rather remarkable machine.
Please welcome back to the stage, David Ross.
How about that amazing video of my dad? He was over 30 years younger than I am today, and he had yet to enter university. To build the first special effects system in Canada at the age of 21 was an incredible accomplishment. A lot has happened since those early days of tubes, including, I should also point out, when my father later designed the world's first solid-state production switcher. So switchers are still a big part of our DNA. So let's talk about what we're doing today. How about the carbonate black Solo? All right, Solo has been a big seller for us because it's a powerful and compact raw switcher at an amazing price. Now, at NAB 2018, we have the newest member of the Solo family, the carbonate black Solo 13. It's available in a frame version and an all-in-one version. The 13 increases the number of SDI inputs from 8 to 12 while still maintaining one of the HDMI inputs. This completely changes the price point of a small switcher with lots of SDI inputs, and the 13 has all of the powerful features found in the original Solo. Remember, this isn't just a 1ME switcher. It's more like a 3ME switcher when you consider that it has two powerful mini-Vs built in. Now, at the higher end of the carbonate family is carbonate black. This product continues to evolve and has significant additions since NAB. We've added support for HDR, high dynamic range, enhanced color correction, a new virtual panel, and many other new features. With the release of version 14, it can now also completely reconfigure itself into a special mode for UHD. All of these added switcher features are being made available to customers free of charge. The carbonate black is an incredibly versatile platform running SD, HD, 3 gig, and 12 gig. The processing hardware of the carbonate black is also the basis of our new Mosaic screen processor and our high performance 444 standalone ultrachrome chroma key. Carbonate black is a really great example of a product that embodies the philosophies of software-defined production. You can buy one frame, and then using software licenses, completely change what the processing hardware does. Now, let's talk about big switchers. New for version 8 software, Acuity now has direct support for the new HDR high contrast video formats of PQ, HLG, as well as S-Log3. We've also expanded our color space to include wide color gamut with the new BT2020 standard in addition to the Legacy 709. These new color spaces are available in both HD and UHD operating modes, so we got you covered now and well into the future. Do you own any products where you say to yourself, hey, why didn't they put in such and such a feature? Well, in Acuity, that feature was probably audio playback in our media stores. So I'm really pleased to announce that in version 8, that's now a standard feature. Another new capability I'd like to highlight is we can now make our 3D DVEs look like an external source in addition to the standard mode of operation where they're built right into the gears. There really isn't any production that Acuity can't handle. I want to emphasize that both Acuity and Carbonite Black offer 12 gig single coax 4K connectivity. This makes UHD easy, and they both really shine when they're connected to our 12 gig native Ultrix routers. And this shouldn't be surprising, because ROS has always been the leader in 12 gig technology. For many applications, 12 gig SDI is a clear choice for simplicity and cost effectiveness. Both Acuity and Carbonite Black also offer upconversion all the way up to 4K. So I'm proud of how the switcher team have made a fantastic range of switchers that are ready for anything. When it comes to IP connectivity though, ROS is doing something a little different than many other players in the industry, and I'm gonna try and explain why. Most switchers today have more inputs than outputs. These inputs and outputs are organized into individual circuit boards that often always offer specialized input and outside output processing, like frame sinks, color correctors, and up converters. When we look at IP, each fiber has an even number of inputs and outputs because they're bidirectional. You pay big dollars for that bandwidth in and out at the IP switch, so wasting it is a big deal, especially at the scale of large-scale production switchers. So to solve this economically, we're recommending using open gear-based SDI to IP conversion packages. There they are. These allow you to physically guarantee that no bandwidth is wasted and that the maximum board space is available for video processing circuitry. So we did the math, and we found out that for today, this is the most cost-effective way to connect fully featured production switches to your network. For those that prefer to have their IP inside the switcher, regardless, we also offer internal conversion on Acuity that supports Evertz Aspen and should shortly support 2110 as well. So this is a complicated subject with lots of trade-offs. So feel free to stop by our stand, have a talk with our experts, let us walk you through it, and I promise we'll skip the marketing speak and give you the clear facts, because that's what we try to do here at ROS. Graphite. Last year, we launched Graphite, a unique ROS all-in-one production system with a real production switcher, real graphics, and a real audio mixer built in. Graphite is finding a home where traditional all-in-one systems just don't cut it. One of the things that we've learned since we launched Graphite is that superior audio support in all-in-ones is a real industry need. To solve this, we launched a new version of Graphite software that dramatically expands our audio I/O capability. We can now connect up to 3 Rave audio boxes, giving you a grand total of 22 stereo channels and 24 mono channels that are controlled by 46 faders. That's a big audio mixer. And to control it, we're adding support for MIDI audio mixer panels. So we're showing the Behringer X-Touch audio panel at our booth. Our name may be ROS Video, but I really have to smile at just how much audio we've been doing lately. Another thing that customers really appreciate about Graphite is that it's literally the only all-in-one with professional-level graphics. To make it even easier to get on air fast, all Graphites now ship with a set of powerful templates for various sports and news applications. These look great right out of the box and are easy to customize with your own color schemes and logos. Last NAB, when we launched Graphite, we also launched an expanded mirror replay system family. They make great companions in sports applications. At NAB this year, we're announcing a new user interface built on our dashboard control system that allows a simplified single operator control over both Graphite and Mira at the same time. And here's what it looks like right behind me. This is useful in certain types of productions, as sometimes you wonder which productions aren't, that where staff is at a premium and operational simplicity is a major consideration. All right, It's time for me to invite our Vice President of Production Workflow and Cloud Solutions to the stage, and he'll be telling you about, guess what? New developments in ROS production workflows and cloud solutions. Sean Snyder, come on up.
Thanks, Dave. Wow, good crowd tonight. You guys having fun? And imagine all the people watching online too. So I got a lot of new announcements. I'm gonna jump right into it. For a long time, Overdrive has been the undisputed worldwide leader in automated production control. Overdrive does it all, producing news at the highest level. Many of the world's largest newscasts rely on Overdrive every single day. And this NAB, we're unlocking those benefits of automation to an entirely new customer base with the introduction of Overdrive plus Graphite. Overdrive and Graphite combined provide a fully automated studio in a compact form factor. There's a lot of power under the hood here. A real switcher, real audio, real graphics, and a real server, all under automated control of Overdrive. And it's available at a killer price, starting at, wait for it, keep waiting, under $100,000. This is a perfect application for primary control rooms in a small market station, for backup control rooms, for live and OTT production, for flight packs, for faith-based production, really anywhere you want to do live production with as few as a single operator. Now, going back, we started with Overdrive and automated production. But over the years, we've rapidly built out an ecosystem of ROS products designed specifically around news and workflow. And while we're talking about news, you have to know I'm going to talk about Inception. One of the things that I routinely get asked is, what makes Inception special? What makes it different? And most of you probably already know, because I've said it 100 times, Inception is built from the ground up with multi-platform in mind, linear, web, and social, all in one user interface. But what you might not know is we actually designed Inception with automated production workflow in mind. It's the only newsroom system on the planet that allows multiple users to be in working on the same script. One user writing script and the other adding production elements like graphics, automation, and server commands at the same time. So what this means is when you're breaking news, you can have somebody in finishing the final pieces of that script while somebody else is coding it. And our customers really notice these time savings. Last year, we launched Inception to the largest customer to date, Rogers Media, out of Toronto, based in Toronto, but all over Canada, really, launched a massive 260 concurrent user newsroom system, fully virtualized, spread across 2 data centers. Now, to give you a size of the scale of this system, one newsroom system serves 6 major markets. They produce content in 5 languages across 4 time zones with more than 25 devices connected. It's fully redundant and it's highly available. But most importantly, this allowed Rogers to adapt to an entirely new workflow, providing that single UI to produce content for the web and produce content for linear at the same time. But more importantly, it also allowed them to share content. They can create content starting the day in Toronto, building out assignments and letting the story evolve through the day, finally signing off at the end of the day in Vancouver. We're really excited about this ongoing partnership with Rogers and continue to partner with them as their ambitions grow. Now, last year I also got to make history by standing on the stage and launching the first MOS-enabled newsroom ever in the cloud. And it's been a pretty successful year for us. But expecting it was going to take us to South Korea this past February at the heart of Discovery Network's live coverage wasn't even in the cards. But that's exactly what happened. So let me tell you a little story. The end of last November, Discovery called us up with a problem. We need a newsroom system, and we need it now. And Inception Cloud was the only solution that was able to not only meet all of their production needs, but it also was able to meet that aggressive schedule. We were able to get them online and trained in a matter of weeks. And this, again, was another very big system. 250 concurrent users, fully redundant, all running in real time in the cloud. And in this case, the users were literally spread all over the globe. Pretty amazing, eh? And our ecosystem just keeps expanding. 3 years ago, we launched Streamline as a graphics MAM, providing work order management, a deep integration with our amazing Expression graphics system, and we've since added self-service graphics workflows with AP and MGN Online. And then we started expanding its capabilities into production. But at NAB this year, we're taking it one step further with an all-new addition for production asset management called Streamline Production. Streamline Production installs locally in your facility, and it can hook up to your existing NAS or SAN-based storage, or link up with your existing Abacus servers, and be able to provide one interface to view and manage the content across all of those platforms and all that storage. You can drag, move content between storage, you can move content between your servers, and you never actually have to ingest it into the MAM. It also provides a full MOS interface for integration with Inception or your existing newsroom system, and ultimately, it's a complete editorial and playout solution at an amazing price. We also are taking it one step further with the launch of a new Tria server, Tria News, at NAB this year. It's a new clip server supporting playback with XDCAM native and AVC intra with no transcode required. What that means to you is you can go from acquisition to playout that much faster. Both Streamline Production and Tria News will be available in May. So last year we launched Inception Enterprise, which I've covered with Rogers, and Discovery, which was a hybrid of enterprise and cloud. And enterprise really scaled the newsroom. It allowed us to build in highly available technologies and make the system really, really heavily redundant and able to scale. This year we've applied that same technology to Streamline. I'm pleased to announce the launch of Streamline Enterprise Edition. Streamline Enterprise combines production and graphics management and really is evolving to the heart of the Ross News ecosystem. What makes it unique is Streamline Enterprise has a feature set designed to serve multiple television stations from one single install. But most importantly, it allows you to evolve that workflow and actually blend cloud storage and local storage as a hybrid, and you'd never actually realize it's happening. We support storage with Amazon, Google, and Microsoft Azure, and it will also be available next month. Now, we've been busy. Our engineering teams are nonstop, but I'm not quite done yet. I have one more announcement. Now, we launched Inception Cloud last year. Can anyone guess what I want to launch this year? So, we've spent the last year evolving Streamline into that heart of the ecosystem. And now we're prepared to send it into the cloud. The launch of Streamline Cloud, the first MOS-enabled asset management platform in the cloud. Thank you. Now, what's cool about Streamline in the cloud is as a customer, you only have to ask yourself two questions. How many users and how much storage? And I also should highlight that all of our cloud solutions are based on concurrent users, not named users. So if you subscribe for 20 users, that's whatever 20 users are in the building at that time, which represents a substantial cost savings versus a lot of other cloud solutions. Streamline Cloud offers everything that you get in the installed version, but it's fully hosted and quite literally takes minutes to set up. Now, everyone's talking about the cloud. And from our perspective, having done this a few times, cloud isn't that hard. Really, fundamentally under the hood, it's a combination of virtualized technologies and management of that platform and orchestration of that platform. What's really hard about public cloud is bridging it to your local network securely. We did this last year with the launch of our Inception Cloud Gateway technology, which allowed you to drive MOS devices locally from a public cloud hosted newsroom system. This year, we've amped up that cloud gateway, providing a full and secure file transfer mechanism and portal inside that, allowing you to, from a hosted streamlined cloud solution, see local contents of your servers, see local contents of your NAS and SANs, and even initiate point-to-point transfers within a facility with the files never actually moving in and out of the cloud. On top of that, you can easily move files from one end of the country to the other with a drag and drop, or create workflow rules where content getting ingest can automatically be mirrored and distributed to many different places. It also has all of the capabilities of the streamlined graphics system that our customers already love today. Launching next month, Streamline Cloud will combine seamlessly with your on-premise newsroom or your on-premise Inception system, or integrates with our Inception Cloud platform for a full editorial end-to-end production platform in the cloud. That's all I got for today. Thanks for your time. Back to you, David.
Thanks, Sean, you've been really busy. As most of you know, Ross Video is a family and employee-owned company. Maybe that's part of why we've attracted such an amazing, passionate, and dedicated team. Many of our experts have been with us for decades. And I want to point out, after 22 fantastic years with Ross, dear friend of mine, Eric Goodmurphy, will be retiring to travel the world and relax on his dock. Eric, we're going to miss you, and I really want to say thank you to you for an amazing job and an absolutely amazing career, and I learned a lot from you. Thanks, Eric. So, Eric has done a great job preparing us for the future with a strong team that's clearly firing on all cylinders. To take you through their latest innovations for the show is our new Vice President of Infrastructure, Nestor Amaya. Come on up, Nestor.
Thank you, David, and thank you, Eric. It's been great to develop our IP strategy together these past few years. One of Eric Goodmurphy's greatest contributions to our industry has been the creation of OpenGear. OpenGear unites the largest ecosystem of manufacturers side by side within the same modular frame, delivering economies of scale and ease of use, all while protecting your freedom to choose. One frame, one control system, uniting a world of suppliers for you to choose from. Now, I'm proud to announce what's next for OpenGear. More power and more fun in a new frame, OGX. Excited about this stuff. OGX, the frame that is powering OpenGear into our future. OGX is designed to meet the needs of both UHD processing and IP. Much more power with better cooling for the latest UHD and IP processing engines. And it's not just more powerful. I think it's gorgeous and cool. It sports Frame Glow. Users can program Frame Glow from a rainbow of flashing colors. It's not just fun, it's functional. For example, color code your rack room based on your channel, signal chain, or whatever you choose. Alarms, Frame Glow can be programmed to signal multiple levels of alarm. For example, loss of signal. OGX is compatible with existing cards. OGX ships in June and will replace the OG3. Here's a quick test. Is OGX for IP or for 12 gig STI? That's right, OGX is for both, IP and 12 gig SDI. In other words, OGX hits the spot. Come by our booth and have a look, and also see it at our partners' booths. Now, let's talk about one of my favorite topics, IP. Through its acquisition of Covelos, a live media networking technology startup, Ross Video has been at the forefront of live IP for many years. With a large and dedicated team dedicated to this transformative technology. And with the help of Ames, we're finally all getting onto the same page. Ross has encoded the Ames roadmap into each and every one of our IP-enabled products. And did you know that Ross is still licensing its core IP technology to leading equipment manufacturers? This is like the open gear of SMPTE 2110. We're helping the industry transition to IP with the highest degree of interoperability and performance. SMPTE 2110 is the standard we've all been waiting for, and SMPTE 2110 is here. Working through Ames, AMWA, AES, SMPTE, we support the continued development of these important standards, and we participate in all of the relevant interops. Now, let's consider for a moment the topic of control. Do you guys agree that we need to have an open API in order to switch IP streams? Yes. Right? I mean, we do this already with SDI-based routers, so why would we take a step back? So here again, Ross is actively supporting open control with NMOS, IS04, IS05, Ember Plus, and even a number of audio protocols such as the ever-popular Dante SAP. That's just to name a few. Open control gives you the freedom to direct Ross products, not just from dashboard, our free and open control system. But it also permits you to control our products from many, many third-party control systems. Ross Video is indeed a world leader in SMPTE 2110 and open control, but don't take my word for it. In December of last year, NEP Australia with Fox Sports delivered the world's first live-to-air HD remote production in SMPTE 2110, and this was achieved with the help of our IP gear. Mark Seeger, Director of Technology at NEP Australia, said that they liked our ability to seamlessly integrate with their chosen control system. We didn't insist on dashboard. We collaborated with them to create a solution to effectively drive their monitors, and Newt was born. SMPTE 2110 with open control now shipping live and in action on Newt and Raptor. Newt is the world's first and only drop-down IP to HDMI UHD converter. Newt is the strong silent type. You'll barely hear a purr. Compact, quiet, and robust enough for you to throw this little guy down into the IP environment of your choice. Newt can scale any wall, zip tie to a post, hide under a desk, behind a display, and three will sit side by side securely on their optional rack shelf. Software-defined production. The mantra of our infrastructure roadmap enables multiple uses and functions using the same device, pay only for what you need thanks to flexible licensing options. For example, Newt is now bidirectional. This optional license allows you to stream two video streams from Newt and to return two camera feeds or whatever feeds. Now, Newt's bigger cousin is Raptor. Raptor is our open gear IP gateway with optional SDP, software-defined processing. Raptor adapts to your changing production requirements at the push of a button. Each Raptor can process up to 12 1080p streams and hundreds of audio streams. That's right, hundreds of audio streams. Software applications like frame sinks, up-down cross converters, logo inserters are coming soon. Five Raptors can be powered by one OGX. I hope you'll come and see our IP gear in action at our booth, the IP showcase, Arista, Cisco, TagVS, one of our partners, and of course at the booths of our OEM partners. Ross embraces software-defined production using live IP networking because it helps you, our customer, do more with less. Software-defined production gives you more agility, scale, and adaptability. But software-defined production is not only possible with IP. So let's look at our software-defined products with 12-gig connectivity. So here's Gator. Gator is our 4K modular processing platform featuring 12 by 12-gig SDI I/O. Up to 10 of these Gators can be powered by one OGX. That's right, 120 IOs in one 2RU chassis. Gator offers software licenses to run applications, again, such as keying or quad frame syncs. That's available today. And coming soon, up-down cross-conversion. ROS is committed to both IP and SDI. You're free to choose whatever transport works best for your business. And Korean NBC chose Gator and Altrix for their 4K live sports production this past February. ROS delivered 12-gig value and performance flawlessly. These products are not experimental. They're mission-proven. All right, we've now covered our modular and our point-of-use product lines. That's Raptor, Gator, Newt. And now it's time to take a closer look at Altrix, our ultimate connectivity platform. I am blown away by the team that developed these products. I can't take credit for it. I'm just blown away. Altrix is all in, unified connectivity and processing. Kind of like that TARDIS in Doctor Who, you know, the box that's bigger on the inside? Or was it big, smaller on the outside? Anyway, so what's in the box? Video routing from 16 to 144 squared, up to 24 software-enabled, low-latency multi-viewers, enabling you to monitor any input or output. Killer 3,000 squared audio routing with processing. That's I/O gain, tone insertion, summing, and more. Those of you in the audience who have ever racked audio embedders and multi-viewers, your jaws must be dropping right now. And that's not all. Altrix also crushes optional software features like gearboxing, clean and quiet switches on every input, frame syncs on every input. This ultra-integrated, ultra-high-definition processing platform has crushed racks of equipment into a compact and economical smart fabric. Just look at how much gear is crushed, disappears into the FR2. Now imagine how much the FR5 can do for you. Believe me, we're not stopping there. More crushing is on the way. Flexible software licensing enables you to adapt Altrix's processing to your needs. No throwaway hardware, pay as you go. Save some serious money with less space, less power, less cooling, less cabling, less weight, less setup time. Altrix is complexity made simple. All right, you can probably tell I love to share magic with you, but my time is up. Thank you, and please welcome back our excellent CEO, Mr. David Ross.
Thanks, Nestor. Great job. Altrix is absolutely amazing. I mean, seriously, if it doesn't blow your mind, you're not paying attention. It's an SDI work of art. But what about IP? IP is a whole different ballgame. We're routing packets instead of switching cross points. In moving to an IP fabric, some of the things that are easy in SDI become a challenge in IP. The COT switch doesn't have any processing or knowledge of the video signal. It simply routes packets. With IP, it's like the early days of SDI when routers just routed and didn't have internal processing like Alteryx. So we need to add these capabilities back into the system to make these COT switches work for video. We have to add back frame syncs, audio clean quiet switching, audio processing, multi-viewing, video format conversion, and we have to add a new one, IP encapsulation conversion, such as going from 2022 to 2110. Which brings us to our one more thing moment. My favorite part of the keynote. Let's roll the video. Tonight, I am super excited to announce Alteryx IP. Here it is, the Alteryx IP Blade. It's real. Any number of SDI I/O cards can be swapped out and replaced with Alteryx IP Blades. Each blade will offer 16 3-gig IP I/O or 8 UHD IP I/O and an impressive 1040 gig and 25 100 gig IP connectivity support, all in one card. This makes the Alteryx FR5 fully AIMS compliant with 2022 and 2110 encapsulation formats. Alteryx is now the perfect bridge from SDI to IP and back again. Let's talk about some of the Alteryx applications for IP. It's a mid-size hybrid core facility router. That's cool. It's an IP frame sync farm. It's an IP connected multi-viewer. It's an IP audio shuffler. It's an IP processing engine. It's an IP audio video clean switch. It's an IP SDI bridge. And an SDI to IP bridge. And because it supports both 2022 and 2110, it's an IP encapsulation converter as well. I should point out, Alteryx can perform all of these functions simultaneously. Alteryx IP is a much needed Swiss Army knife for IP facilities. Now, Alteryx IP is currently in development. Okay, we've told you. This board will unlock even more of the hidden magic inside the Alteryx FR5. We'll be announcing a firm shipping date at IBC in September. So come to the booth and see how Alteryx can help you solve today's problems and where it can take you in the future. I kind of thought you'd want a heads up on that when you're designing your facilities. Now, I hope that as promised, we've knocked your socks off with the many, many announcements that we've made tonight. And given that you are now sockless, we have a solution for that as well. So just for fun, come and pick up your brand new pair of raw socks at our reception next door. Here's what they look like. They're very comfortable. I've been wearing mine all night. And if you stop by our booth, don't forget to also ask for your classy Ross Red sunglasses to help you survive that bright Vegas sunshine. So the reception is through the curtains over there. Thank you for coming. Have a great NAB.